Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining using policy-based routing over an MPLS-TE topology. I'm passionate about turning complex network and telecom concepts into clear, straightforward explanations. Learning should be easy and practical, and that's exactly what I aim to deliver. If you enjoy this kind of content, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to stay updated. We've been looking at MPLS traffic engineering, and we've established TE tunnels on an MPLS-TE topology over the past few videos. And this is the topology we've been working on, where we have configured MPLS-TE with an OSPF underlay and RSVP-TE. We've created an LSP tunnel from PE1, which is the head-end router, to PE2, which is the tail-end router. Our MPLS-TE topology is now up and running with a single tunnel already established. We're looking at the various routing solutions for routing traffic over established TE tunnels. And we've already looked at static routing as well as the auto route announce and the auto route destination features. In this video, we'll be taking a look at policy-based routing as an option to route traffic down a TE tunnel. Let's examine this option and see what that looks like. So what's so special about PBR when applied to an MPLS-TE topology? Well, nothing really. It's just another option for routing traffic down a TE tunnel. Now remember, the major challenges involved with routing when using LSP tunnels is the fact that they're unidirectional. So your conventional link state routing protocols, which require bidirectional communication to create peerings, will not work out of the box. We need to either tweak how they function to allow the tunnel to participate in the shortest path first algorithm, or we need to use some other technique to route traffic down them. PBR works just fine in this context, and there's nothing really special we need to configure to get it to work. It works just fine with TE tunnels, and that's why we're showcasing it here. So how do we apply PBR to route traffic down this MPLS-TE tunnel? Well, we create a route map that matches the traffic we want, and we set the exit interface to be the tunnel itself. For our purposes here, we'll match traffic that's destined for the 192.168.12.0/24 network, which is the customer network behind CE2 here. Before we configure it, let's take a look at PE1's routing table. Now, I've removed all of the previous configurations that we had added in previous videos, including the auto route features and the static routing entries. In our routing table, we only see pure OSPF learned routes and some directly connected networks. You can see that the route to 192.168.12.0/24 is in our routing table, and it has been learned via OSPF as expected. You can also see that equal cost load balancing is taking place, because there are two equal cost routes to get to the destination. Now let's configure PBR to route our intended traffic down tunnel 1. Now if you haven't seen how to configure route maps or access lists, or if you don't know much about policy-based routing in general, this may be new to you. To learn more about these constructs, I suggest that you do some research. There's a lot of content out there that will give you the basics of these features. I'll put it on my to-do list to cover it in the near future. But for now, our implementation here is quite simple, so you should be okay. Let's start by creating our access list that will match the desired traffic. We want to match any traffic that has a destination address within the 192.168.12.0/24 destination subnet. So we can do this by issuing the following permit statement. This will match any source address, and it'll match the destination addresses within this subnet. There's an explicit deny at the end of the ACL, so it denies all other traffic that does not match. Next, we'll create the route map that will use the ACL to match the specific traffic, and we'll apply our routing policy. So any packet that matches the IP addresses found in this ACL will have this set statement applied to it. And this set statement essentially says, send it out of the Tunnel 1 interface. Now we've created our ACL and our route map. We now have to apply it to the PE1 router. Where do we apply it? We apply it on the incoming interface from which we expect our packet to arrive. In this particular case, we want PBR to act upon any traffic that arrives from our CE1 router. So we must apply this to the CE1 facing interface, which is Gigabit Ethernet 01. We can apply the route map using the IP policy command on Gigabit Ethernet 01. By issuing this command and referencing our route map, we have now completed our PBR configuration to route our traffic down the tunnel interface. Now, to verify our work, we can't just look at our routing table on PE1 because PBR does not actually change the routing table. It acts as an exception to the normal routing behavior based on the routing table. PBR takes place before any standard routing lookup in the routing table itself. Now let's ping from CE1 to PE1. Here we're pinging from CE1 to our destination network, and we're using the IP address of this loopback interface as the source. It doesn't really matter what source address we use, since our ACL will match any source address. We see that the ping is indeed successful. But was our tunnel used? Let's take a look at our route map. We can see here that we have 5 matches, and the set clause is set to tunnel 1. So these 5 packets were successfully policy-based routed, if we can say that, via the tunnel. So that's how we apply PBR to route traffic down a TE tunnel that has already been established. Once again, there's nothing special about PBR as far as traffic engineering goes. It simply works with TE tunnels because PBR is local to the headend router and it deals only with traffic going in an outward direction. For this reason, PBR is a viable solution for routing traffic down a TE tunnel within an MPLS-TE topology. For now, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to leave a comment. I'm always happy to read them and to respond. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.